Next thing you're going to need to do is you're going to need to strip about an inch from each of the ends of these wires. So what you do is you get a normal wire stripper. Here you go. Probably put it in the smallest one you can because this is a pretty thin wire. Go ahead and hold it. And there you go. You strip that piece very nicely. Now you're going to go ahead and strip the other side. And this just comes with practice. Go ahead and strip it. Well, that one. Just go ahead and pull it out. Go to the smallest size. Strip it. And there you go. You've stripped that wire. Don't get frustrated when you do this. It just takes a little practice. Again, let's go ahead and strip these other wires down. There you go. In fact, I can't believe I'm sort of getting this on the first go, so I don't want to jinx myself with this, but let's go ahead and strip it. There you go. Put your two wires aside. Get your longer wire, and you're going to go ahead and strip this. Get it at the smallest one you can. There you go. Nice job. Nice clean job. And you really, really want to use wire strippers because it just gets a little too frustrated if you don't have this. Because it gets a little bit hard to strip the wire. There you have it. Got all your wires stripped. Just about an inch on each side. Because don't forget that the rubber that's around this wire insulates this, so you have to have this open to charge, and this is why you go ahead and strip the ends of it. But you don't want to strip it here because you want to keep it insulated. But you can still let the flow of electrons go through so you can make your telegraph.